In today's video, I will show you how to make this monthly budget. Like I said in the ending of last video, most of the things that we use today, you already learned. If you forgot some things, just watch video 1 again. Not only will I repeat a lot of functions from video 1, I will also teach you some new tricks that are really handy to use. The sign I made is very simple because I don't like designing that much. If you make this monthly budget for yourself, you can make the design as hard or fancy as you would like. So let's get started.
We'll first make like the formulas and the tables, and then we'll do the design stuff. You can do it the other way around, but for me it makes more sense to do it that way. Okay, I'll make a sheet, so let's get started. So we'll first start with a table. Let's make the table here, date, an amount, a description, like this, date, amount, description, category. For the date, let's do 0109. Let's say that we're doing a different name, we'll do March, because why not, 2022. Like that. So now we have this. We can drag it down like this. So yeah, amount. It doesn't really make sense because nobody does it, so we'll change it a little bit. 03, 3 this. Okay. So let's say that is 12, 03, 2022. Like this is 14. 14. 15, 21, and the last one, let's say, yeah, 31. So description will be pocket money. Of course you can change the dates amount like to your own budget. So yeah, work description, work, so like salary, birthday, it was your birthday and you got like a nice present. Pocket like birthday, cinema, my back because you paid for somebody and you got the money back. Then pocket money again, and more pocket money. For the category, you want to like make some category. So we'll go to data and then to data validation. And here you see like different times. We want this one. We'll go to setting. We want a list, so not in between. Yes, like this. Source, we'll first write. The first arc is pocket money. The second category will be work. And the other will be refunds. For example, the cinema. Another. This one will be other. And then press OK. So now you can see we can select which category we want. So let's drop it down. Pocket money, work. Let's change it to salary. Let's make this work. Birthday, like other. Cinema refund, pocket money is pocket money. Pocket money, pocket money. Yeah, to make it more clear, we can do it like this. So yeah, So we'll see, we now have the category with description amount. Oh, make a nice amount, so we'll go here. We will go home, money, more accounting. Macedonian dinar, like this. So, and this is the income, and this is the expenses. Expenses. So, yeah. So, we also have here date, amount, description, and category. Alright, so the first will be like 1403. An amount of 200 for a birthday cake. You bought a birthday cake. And then on 1503 you have an amount of 146, a train, because you went with the train to the cinema. And then you also, of course, had the tickets of the cinema. That was 366, cause and you paid for yourself and for your friend. That's why he gave you money back. So cinema. And then also, well, let's say 1703. You went to the grocery store. And also on the 18th of March you went to repair your key for 100 dinar. Key repair or key copy, let's say you want to copy your key. And then you also went another time to the cinema because you really like movies. You did that on the 29th of March. This time you went alone, so it's 183. So cinema. We'll also make categories here. So we'll pass here, we go to data. Data validation, the first one. We want a list, like a drop-down list. So, and then the source, the first one will be food, travel. Make this one for your own, just put things in the list that makes sense. Every time you want to add another word to the list, just press a comma like this, and then it will add it to the list. So for example, activities, for example then the cinema, and then a personal stuff for and other. Just always nice to have another. Press OK. We drag it down. The birthday cake is food. The train is travel. The cinema is an activity. The shito is also food. Key copy is other or personal. And this one is also an activity. So now we'll see you have this one. And we have this one. So we'll now make it a nice table. But first, let's make this an amount of money. Just write M. Press enter. Ok. Like this. So I will now make it a nice table. Format this table. This one is nice. My table has a header. Here as well. Format. My table has a header. Like this. So yeah, now we have this. Now we can like make this all a little bigger or not. Like this is more design stuff, so it's completely up to you how you want it. Let's all make it like this and here as well. So like this, of course, if you can still like change this, if you want this one closer, not that close. Alright, so now we'll look into the total amount you had income. So total. The total income this month was some. Was this. And your total expensive total is some. This. So now we have this number and this number. Now we can make a saved this month. So that means like saved this month or not saved this month. So we can do that. Saved this month. So then if we say if we want to do the income minus the expenses. And then we see if we saved this much. We can put a conditional formatting on it. If it's greater than 0, we will fill it with a light green and the font can be a darker green. Like this. Why is it not applying? Manage rules. Say 15 if it is bigger than. It is bigger. If it's greater than. If it's greater than. Let's write this like 0. Like that. And also, of course. If it is lower than, less than, less than 0. Yes, like this. So, for example, if we have now a really big number here, you will see it is minus. Let's make it slightly bigger. Or we'll do it like this. You'll see if it's minus, it comes to red. So now we have saved this month. Now we're going to add up the category. So you'll see how much you spent on each category. So we write category and then total. So the first category will be pocket money. And then is some if. Some if, and then we'll select this one. The category will be then if it is pocket money. Some if, so the range, if it's this criteria, it needs to be pocket money, and then we need to calculate this amount, so all of this. So it will look in this range for pocket money. If there's pocket money, it will cut this one here, the pocket money. So in this case, pocket money, so 200, pocket money, 200, pocket 200, 200, so in total 800. We'll do the same for all the categories, work, refund, and other. So we'll if we drag it, that will be the same. And then we can just change this to work. You can change this one to refund. And we can change this to other. And then it will calculate it. And here we can make it a currency. Like this. We'll also do that here, category, total, for example, food, travel, activities, personal, and other. If, some if in this range, is food, then it needs to add this amount, 700, that would make sense, food, 200, food, 500, and total 700, so that makes perfectly sense. Let's change this to travel. Let's change this to activities. You can also just do this, that's easier. And then you can just do it like this. That also works. It's total fine. Doesn't really matter. Accounting. I don't know why that went, but we do. We want this one like this. What happened to this one? Activities. Why is it not showing? It's too big. Activities, activities. So here's a mistake in the spelling. That's okay because of data validation. Activities like that. Oh, now it's just all food. That's okay. Travel. Activities, see the, that's food, key copy is, let's say other, cinema is activities, and this one is empty, so just do it like that. Personal is nothing, so that makes sense. So yeah, now you can see what you spent on each category. So we have this, so now we can make this nice bar graph. So let's do that. We have income and expense. When you make a graph, always make sure you have a table. So in this case, is it income? And then it is, this one is the income and this one is the expense. Like that. Insert. Oh no, I like this one. So we'll do this one. In total, total income, total expenses. Let's change this one to green and this one to red. Let's make this a more darker green, like this. We can just do it like that and put it over the table, or we can make this like a nice white color font so you also cannot see it like this. That's also possible. Now we can work more on the design. Of course, this is not necessary, but like this looks better than this. So we'll write here month and here March. Let's just do it like this, month, and now I can make it bigger, like that, and March can also be slightly bigger, March and center, month, March, we can just insert an entire row, insert entire row, like this. And then we can make this also merge and center and make this also slightly bigger. Same for here. Which font was this? 14. Let's make this also 14. Yeah, then we can change like the color, of course, if we want. Not like that. And then, yeah, we can just make this. We can make this whole background one color. Here like this. Yes, like this, and then we can, no. I'll just select it like this. And we can make this more gray, like this. Now I don't like how close this is on here, so we'll insert a column, move this one here, make this a little smaller, and make this also this color. Or just do it like this. No, this needs to be a little darker. Just like this, and we can do it like this. And this one slightly darker again. I don't like this. Like this. This one is what I need. Perfect. So yeah, now we have this. Of course we can, like, it's not total in the middle, so we can like move this. So this is like mostly design, it's not really that important, but I just want this nice. We can just put it here. Now we see this. I don't want that, so let's fill this up with this. No, it's not visible anymore. And we can just do it like this, or any other way you want it. Maybe this is better. Let's move this back a lot. So yeah, this is mostly like personal. Like, you can do it like this. That's also possible. Maybe that was nice. Slightly lighter. Not that, it's still lighter. So yeah. This is really personal, it doesn't really matter. Make it nice. Oh, this one, 9 still. Boom. And also here, line color. Not like that. Line color. This one. Line style. Thin. Like that. Perfect. So yeah, we can also move this, just copy paste it, or no, that's not better. So yeah, so then you have your own monthly budget. Of course you can make this as big as possible, you don't need to have any of this, but this is how it works. So that was the last video of our Excel course online. I hope you enjoyed the series and you learned something from it. If you only wanted to learn like the really basic without all the formulas, that's completely fine. I still hoped you enjoyed then those videos. If you want to learn more about Word or PowerPoint, check out also our other videos. So yeah, that's it.